Hi, in this tutorial, we are going to slice an object using a lightsaber we made last time. First, create a blueprint as actor type and click to open a window. Next, click the Add component to add the cube component and procedural mesh component. Click the magnifying glass button on the static mesh of the cube component to go to the folder where cube mesh is located and click the cube mesh to open the window. Check the Allow CPU Access in the Detail window, click the Auto Convex Collision in the Collision item, and then click the Apply in the Created window to make a collision. Return to the blueprint and click the cube component. Set the collision preset in the detail to the no collision and check the hidden in game. Next, click the procedural mesh component. Set the collision preset in detail to the block all and check the use complex as simple complex. After clicking the construction script window, create the copy procedural mesh node and connect it with the construction script. Next, drag the cube and procedural mesh to the blueprint to create a node as get type, and connect it to the copy procedural mesh node like the video. When you place the blueprint with the appropriate size in the world and play it, the object doesn't fall from the air. Go back to the blueprint and click the procedural mesh component. Check the simulate physics in detail. Then the physics laws will apply to the object and it will fall to the ground. Next, click the lightsaber blueprint we created to open the window. Click the Add component in the lightsaber part to create the mesh component without mesh. After that, place the mesh component created on the tip of the sword and add 90 degrees in all directions. After setting the collision preset of the mesh component and blade meshes custom, make their setting like the video. Next, right-click on the blade mesh and click Add Event to create the overlap and end overlap node. Then, go into the character blueprint and create one bool variable. Let's name the variable as slice. Go back to the Lightsaber blueprint, create two branch nodes, and connect them to the begin overlap and end overlap nodes, respectively. Next, create a get player pawn node, and drag the pin to the node to create a third person character node. Make the third person character node pure cast. Drag the pin of the third-person character node to call the slice variable in the form of get and connect it to the two branch nodes. Next, create the do once node and connect it to the branch node connected to the begin overlap node. Next, create the sequence node and connect it to the branch node, which is connected to the end overlap node, and connect the first pin of the sequence node to the do once node. Next, drag the other component pin of the begin overlap and cast to the procedural mesh component node, then connect it to the do once node. Next, create the slice procedural mesh node by dragging the pin from the procedural mesh component, like the video, and connect the slice procedural mesh node to the sequence node. Drag the empty static mesh, which was created as a child to the blade component, and create it as a node in the blueprint. Then, create the getWorldLocation node and getUpVector node and connect it to the empty static mesh, known to specify the location and direction of the sword. Connect the getWorldLocation node and getUpVector node to the slice procedural mesh node and set the slice procedural mesh node like the video. The cap material of the slice procedural mesh node represents the material inside when cut. So set the sword part of the lightsaber as material or material instance. Next, after creating the set simulate physics node, check the simulate and connect it to the slice procedural mesh node. Next, create the add impulse node and connect it to the set simulate physics node and slice procedural mesh node. Set the impulse value of the add impulse node to about 300. Check the vel change so that the mesh receives an impact when you cut the mesh. Lastly, create the isValid node and connect it between the sequence node and slice procedural mesh node, like the video. After compiling and saving, open the character blueprint window. Create another pin on the sequence node. After bringing the slice variable to the form of set, create the delay node and connect them each other. Set the duration of the delay node to 0.1 and the slice variable to true. And once more, bring the slice variable in the form of a set and connect it to the stop node, which is connected to the play montage node and do once node. Compile and return to the content browser. Now play and run the animation near the mesh blueprint you place. You can see the mesh being cut by the lightsaber.